Let me paint you a picture. You're using your screen reader with a Braille display, you arrive at a website, and it asks you to sign in with some username or password. And then you hear this.
Type in text, computer Braille.
Computer Braille? What in the world does that mean, and why does it matter? Well, that's what we're going to be talking about today on Tech Tip Tuesday. All right, so today we are talking about computer Braille. First, we're going to talk about what it is and where you might use it, and then we're going to discuss two different patterns that will help you read and write computer Braille on your Braille display.
What is computer Braille?
Well, computer Braille is exactly what it sounds like. It's a Braille code used when typing something technical, usually for a computer. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why can't we just use regular old Unified English Braille when typing on a computer? Well, the benefit of computer Braille is that there is a one-to-one correspondence. That means that each and every Braille cell corresponds to one print symbol. That means when you write a capital A, for instance, you won't be typing capital indicator, then A. In computer Braille, that capital A will be one Braille symbol. And likewise, if you try to type the number 1 in computer Braille, it won't be a number sign and then the number 1. In computer Braille, that number 1 will be one Braille symbol. Okay, so when would you need to use computer Braille? Well, anytime that you're using a Braille display with a Perkins-style keyboard, like this one, and you need to write something technical. That might be an email address and a password to sign into a website, or if you're getting into coding, it could be a programming language inside a text editor or an IDE. So, you ready to learn some computer Braille? All right, let's go. So the first thing you need to know is that computer Braille is composed of 8 dots, not 6 like most Braille codes. The regular 6 dots are marked with the exact same dot numbers, right? Dots 1, 2, and 3 are placed up and down on the left side, and dots 4, 5, and 6 on the right side, just like normal UEB. But there are 2 extra dots in computer Braille. There is a dot 7 that falls below dot 3 on the left side, and there's a dot 8 that falls below dot 6. On your Braille keyboard, when typing in computer Braille, your backspace key becomes dot 7, and your enter key becomes dot... Yeah, you guessed it, it's dot 8. So now let's learn some computer Braille. Today, I'm going to teach you 2 patterns, and with that information, you should be able to type a simple username and password. You ready?
Pattern 1. Make capitals with dot 7.
So that's exactly what it sounds like. If you want to make any letter capitalized, you just need to add dot 7 to your Braille cell. That means a capital A would be dots 1 and 7. Capital B would be dots 1, 2, and 7, and so on.
Pattern 2. Numbers are dropped.
So in computer Braille, anytime you'd like to write a number, you're going to forget the number sign, and just like in Nemeth code, that number will be dropped down to the lower half of the cell. For example, the number 1 in UEB is usually dot 1, but in computer Braille, it is dot 2, right? The number 5 in UEB is dots 1 and 5, but in computer Braille, we're going to drop it down to dots 2 and 6. Now, there are tons of other symbols that you might need, like a period or quotation marks or an exclamation point. Well, for all of those, I want you to take a look at our blog post attached to this video. In that post, we have included all of the information from this video, as well as a list of the most common computer Braille symbols. Now, if you are new to Braille displays or are not sure how to get started, we have a brand new curriculum coming out that I think you're going to like. We are just getting ready to announce what that curriculum is and when it will be launched, but if you've made it to this part of the video, trust me, this curriculum is for you. Now, the best way to stay up to date on those announcements is to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon here on this video. And if you have a colleague or friend interested in getting started with a Braille display, go ahead and send them our channel. This semester, we are covering all things refreshable Braille, so don't miss out. Until then, have a great week. We'll be right here next week for another Tech Tip Tuesday.